Please stand.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who chose to manifest the blessed hope of your eternal kingdom by the toil of Saints John de Brebeuf, Isaac Jogues, and their companions, and by the shedding of their blood, graciously grant that through their intercession, the faith of Christians may be strengthened day by day through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you were dead in your transgressions and sins in which you once lived, following the age of this world, following the ruler of the power of the air, the spirit that is now at work in the disobedient. All of us once lived among them in the desires of our flesh, following the wishes of the flesh and the impulses. And we were by nature children of wrath, like the rest. But God, who is rich in mercy, because of the great love he had for us, even when we were dead in our transgressions, brought us to life with Christ. By grace we have been saved, raised us up with him, and seated us with him in the heavens in Christ Jesus, that in the ages to come he might show the immeasurable riches of his grace in his kindness to us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from you, it is the gift of God. It is not from works, so no one may boast. For we are his handiwork, created in Christ Jesus for good works, that God has prepared in advance that we should live in them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord made us, we belong to him.
The Lord made us, we belong to him.
Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful song.
The Lord made us, we belong to him.
Know that the Lord is God, he made us. His we are, his people, the flock he tends.
The Lord made us, we belong to him.
Enter his gates with thanksgiving, his courts with praise.
The Lord made us, we belong to him.
Give thanks to him, bless his name, for he is good. The Lord whose kindness endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations.
The Lord made us. We belong to him.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Someone in the crowd said to Jesus, "Teacher, tell my brother to share the inheritance with me." He replied to him, "Friend, who appointed me as your judge and arbiter?" Then he said to the crowd, "Take care to guard against all greed. For though one may be rich, one's life does not consist of possessions." Then he told them a parable. There was a rich man whose land produced a bountiful harvest. He asked himself, "What shall I do? For I do not have space to store my harvest." And he said, "This is what I shall do. I shall tear down my barns and build larger ones. There I shall store all my grain and other goods, and I shall say to myself, 'Now as for you, you have so many good things stored up for many years. Rest, eat, drink, be merry.' But God said to him, 'You fool, this night your life will be demanded of you. And the things you have prepared, to whom will they belong?' Thus will it be for the one who stores up treasure for himself, but is not rich in what matters to God." The Gospel of the Lord. Good morning. It's a powerful image. Powerful image. Very clear. Jesus says that there's this man who has many possessions. He lives in an agricultural environment, so for them it's about a barn filled with wheat and grain. For us it's a second house, vacation homes and cars and storages filled with possessions, houses jam-packed with unnecessary things, bank accounts that inflate perhaps with people over time. Well, maybe not our personal situation, but certainly we live in a society in which that exists in a big way. People stacking up and racking up credit card debt unnecessarily. For what? Not about surviving, but when people are attracted and attached to things they don't need. That's what we're getting at here. For what? For what? What's the good of it? What's it for? What's its use? What's its purpose? God says to this man, "You fool. You fool. He spent all these years slaving and laboring to build bigger barns, to fill them with more stuff. And that very night, his life would be demanded of him." It gives all of us a kind of a pause about getting our priorities straight, right? Greed drives a lot of people's lives. Greed keeps people up and running. But what are they running to? Maybe a better question is, what are they running from? St. Teresa of Avila said, "When you have God, you lack nothing." God alone suffices. We say that love alone is its own reward. Love is its own reward, you know. You know the story of a couple. She's suffering and hurting physically, but filled with the Lord. He's supposedly physically okay, but empty. In the eyes of the world, he's good. She's not. in the eyes of God, she's great, he's not. That's how it works. Love alone is its own reward. Love is its own reward. Love stores up treasures in heaven. They say that the treasures of the church are the mouths of the poor. Right? And the same true for all of us. Our treasure, we could store up the bank account that will never grow vulnerable to moth or decay, as Jesus says, is the treasury in heaven, which is stored up by good works, is stored up by love and charity. And when we consider our life not our own, but that we are given to God, our life is not ours, our life is God's, then there's a certain freedom in that. There's a certain freedom in that. I mean, we know many people have had the stories. They worked all their life and racked up their 401k and their retirement and their pension, and they retire and they die, you know? And sometimes it's tragic. And not everybody is a greedy person, but we have to get our priorities straight and learn that the moment to live is now. Don't wait for the future to begin living. Some people have that idea that when I retire, that's when I'm really going to start to live. No, we have to learn how to sanctify the present moment in our state of life, whether we're retired now, whether we're working, whether we're on disability, whether whatever our status, single, married, celibate, every moment is a moment to be lived as a gift, to be received from God as a gift, and to be given back to him as a gift. And not to worry about accumulating and accumulating, but rather in giving. And the measure with which you measure out, Jesus says, will be measured back to you, pressed down and shaken over. Okay, what are those treasures in heaven? They're all the little good things you do on a daily basis. To the eyes of God, no act is insignificant. No little detail, no little act of charity, or no little chore that we do for the good of others is lost on God. And so there's a freedom in living our life without worrying about clutching. Greed wants us to clutch. It wants to hold on. It wants to protect, right, with things. Christ on the cross, his hands are not clutching. They're open. It's a gift. His body is a gift. His life was a gift. And our living our lives, if we don't clutch, but rather we open and our hands are generous, we know that the Lord will give back with a measure that will overflow. God is good, and he's a generous God. He's not a stingy God. He's not a stingy God. So be bold. Be bold in how you give of your life. Your life is meant to be a gift given back to God. And every day, for all of us, no matter our state in life, there are 1,000 different ways we can love God and others. That's it. And in fact, there's a great freedom in that. You get to get up in the morning and come here and receive Jesus, and you get to go out and you get to think of all the different ways and different circumstances in which you can give your life as a gift to others, right? And even in the simplest, smallest ways. And if you live your life like that, as a gift and then given back as a gift, you store up treasure in heaven. When you live your life concerned about yourself and all your problems and all your miseries and trying to figure out how to just solve, you know, what you need in this moment, right? When we live that way, we are miserable. We are miserable. But when we live our life as a gift for God and others, it's interesting how God will find a way to solve all those problems and give us the grace to make the gift of our life. So that's the message. We think less of ourselves and more about those good works, those good deeds, acts of charity that will store up a great treasure. Then when we get to heaven, it's going to be even that much greater. But you know what? It's not like we're going to live a cheap life now and have a rich life there. No, we're going to live a life rich in love and grace here now, because love is its own reward. Charity, doing good, is its own reward. You don't need payment because God gives you his life inside of you. Grace is its own reward. Recalling our most merciful Lord, let us offer our prayers. For all church leaders, may they be guided by the Holy Spirit in leading their flocks, especially Cardinal Dolan and all priests of the Archdiocese of New York, let us pray to the Lord. For government leaders, international organizations, and for all who seek an increase in charity throughout the world, may they be inspired by the Lord's example, storing up treasure in heaven, we pray to the Lord. For all God's children who lack the basic necessities of life, may their needs be met, and may they be blessed with the strength and support they need. Let us pray to the Lord. For this faith community, may the Holy Spirit guide our actions in making this a house of worship and a welcoming place to others. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who have died in the light of faith, may they rest in the peace and the love of Jesus Christ. Let us pray to the Lord. For the soul of Tom McWilliam, for whom we offer this holy mass, we pray to the Lord. That the heroic examples of St. Isaac Jogues, St. John de Brebeuf, and their martyrs here in New York, who gave their life to give witness to Christ, to evangelize the native peoples, we ask that we would imitate their self-sacrifice in giving their life for Christ, we pray to the Lord. We pause now to remember our private intentions. We pray to the Lord. Ever-loving and gracious Father, we humbly ask that you hear and answer the petitions we place before you today. We ask them through the intercession of the sorrowful and immaculate heart of Mary and through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, and become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, we pray, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, which we offer to your majesty in commemoration of the blessed martyrs John de Brebeuf, Isaac Jogues, and companions, that it may lead us to obtain pardon and confirm us in perpetual thanksgiving through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the blood of your blessed martyrs, John de Brebeuf, Isaac Jogues, and companions, poured out like Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear you witness through Christ our Lord. And so with the powers of heaven we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end, we acclaim. Holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Timothy, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, especially Tom McWilliam. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty, Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Unless a grain of wheat falls into the ground and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat. But if it dies, it produces much fruit. Alleluia. Thank you. Let us pray. We have received your heavenly gifts, rejoicing at this feast day, O Lord. Grant, we pray, that we, who in the divine banquet proclaim the death of your Son, may merit to be partakers with the holy martyrs in his resurrection and his glory, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Mass is ended. Go in peace. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl throughout the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Immaculate Mary, your praises we sing. You reign now in splendor with Jesus our King. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Ave, Ave Maria.
Hello?
Recitation of the Holy Rosary from Holy Cross Church. Let us begin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he shall come to judge the living and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners,
Thank you, Jesus, for waking us up this morning. Thank you for your mercy, for your blessings, for my children, grandchildren, and my great-granddaughter, especially for Tiana, for everyone who has access to pray for them. Special prayers for Arnaldo Silva, Jesus Alvarez, Sabrina Barcero, for all the souls in purgatory who have no one to pray for them. May the perpetual light continue to shine upon them. For all our parishioner family who cannot make it here today, special prayers for Monica, for Miss Helen, Miss Morris, Barbara, and also his name, Noel. And for peace and justice in this world. Amen.
For all the school children and the teachers who are struggling very much to try to keep up with their education, we pray to the Lord.
I'd like to thank God for all the blessings He has given me, for this blessed day that we have, for all persecuted Christians around the world, for all the victims of the Corona-19 virus, living and deceased, for the homeless, the sick, the indigent, for every man, woman, and child suffering from abuse, abandonment, oppression, or addiction, for all of our first responders, for all the patients and staff at every nursing home and hospital around the world. May God bless them and protect them all. Amen.
Not to mention, also, let us pray for the people who are suffering from mental illness, addiction, financial problems, suicide ideations. Let us pray. Amen.
The first joyful mystery, the Annunciation. Gospel according to Luke, when the angel Gabriel had come to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those who most need of thy mercy. Lord Jesus, have mercy on us. Virgin Mary, help us.
Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother.
fourth joyful mystery, the presentation of the baby Jesus in the temple, from the gospel according to Luke, when the day came to purify them, according to the law of Moses, the couple brought him up to Jerusalem so he could be presented to the Lord. For it is written in the law of the Lord, every firstborn male shall be consecrated to the Lord. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins. Save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those who are in most need of your mercy. Lord Jesus, have mercy on us. Virgin Mary, help us. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. and on the whole world.
Holy Mary,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Holy Mother of God,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Holy Virgin of Virgins,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Mother of Christ,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Mother of the Church,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Mother of Divine Grace,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Mother Most Pure,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Mother Most Chaste,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Mother Inviolate,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Mother Undefiled,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Mother Most Amiable,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Mother Most Admirable,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Mother of Good Counsel,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Mother of our Creator,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Mother of our Savior,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Virgin Most Prudent,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Virgin Most Venerable,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Virgin Most Renowned,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Virgin Most Powerful,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Virgin Most Merciful,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Virgin Most Faithful,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Mirror of Justice,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Seat of Wisdom,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Cause of our Joy,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Spiritual Vessel,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Vessel of Honor,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Singular Vessel of Devotion,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Mystical Rose,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Tower of David,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Tower of Ivory,
pray for us and on the whole world.
House of Gold,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Ark of the Covenant,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Gate of Heaven,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Morning Star,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Health of the Sick,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Refuge of Sinners,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Comforter of the Afflicted,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Queen of Angels,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Queen of Patriarchs,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Queen of Prophets,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Queen of Apostles,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Queen of Martyrs,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Queen of Confessors,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Queen of Virgins,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Queen of All Saints,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Queen of the Clergy,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Queen of Families,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Queen conceived without original sin,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Queen assumed into Heaven,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Queen of the Most Holy Rosary,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Queen of Peace,
pray for us and on the whole world.
Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us, spare us, O Lord.
Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world,
graciously hear us, O Lord.
Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us, O Lord.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. Grant, we beseech you, O Lord God, that we, your servants, may enjoy perpetual health of mind and body, and by the glorious intercession of the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, be delivered from present sorrow and possess eternal joy through Christ our Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell on the third day. He rose again from the dead.
us.
O pure and sweet.
O Virgin, defend us.
O pure and sweet.
Our Lady, Queen of the Home,
pray for us.